Sikh Khalistani militants in Canada. And the second is the question of interference in Canada by India, which has been cited by Canada's own intelligence agencies. Did neither of those topics come up?
No, they both came up. Over the years with Prime Minister Modi, we've had many conversations on both of those issues.
Neither of those topics?
Obviously, Canada always defend freedom of expression.
And this is what sources are now telling us here at CNN News 18 on day two of the ongoing G20 summit here in the national capital. The Prime Minister Narendra Modi and the Canadian Prime Minister Justin Trudeau are expected to engage in the India-Canada pull-aside talks. These pull-aside talks come after India's multiple concerns regarding growing Khalistan extremism and Canada pausing the trade deal with the national capital. So this is what we're picking up by the means of sources telling us what the pull aside between the Prime Minister and Justin Trudeau could look like. Let's also now bring in our colleague Siddharth, who in fact is getting us this crucial information. Siddharth, as far as the issue of extremism and Khalistan is concerned, this has been an ongoing concern for India with the kind of events that we've seen in the past. Many also possibly feeling that the Canadian authorities or the government has possibly gone soft, and that is why you continue to see a pattern of these incidents. What are sources telling you as far as the pull aside between both the leaders are concerned?
Well, the sources are telling us that this meeting is expected to take place later in the day, and perhaps it's not a bilateral meet. They have specifically mentioned this, that it is not going to be a bilateral meet, but it is leveled down from a bilateral meet, which is pull-aside meet. And Prime Minister Modi is surely going to raise the issue of Khalistan on Canadian soil. The sources have confirmed this to us.
Thanks for joining us. I'm Akshay Tandon. Prime Minister Justin Trudeau will be spending at least another night in India because of technical issues with his plane. Canada's delegation was set to depart from New Delhi tonight following the G20 summit, but now the Prime Minister's office says the issues with the plane can't be fixed overnight. CTV's Annie Bergeron Oliver is traveling with the Prime Minister and the delegation. So Annie, you'll be grounded for at least another night. What can you tell us about the situation?
Well, that's right. The Prime Minister and his entire Canadian delegation, including media traveling with the Prime Minister, were supposed to depart from Canada tonight, but that's not going to be happening. In a statement from the Prime Minister's office, they told us that the Canadian Armed Forces discovered a technical issue with the plane shortly before departure. They say this technical issue is severe enough that it cannot be fixed overnight. So now, essentially, we're in a bit of a scrambling pattern here. There were visas that were required to get into the country. You can see that there's a lot of moving pieces here, trying to get more hotel rooms for the entire delegation, and just trying to figure out, can this plane be fixed by tomorrow, or how do you get this entire delegation back to Canada? There's probably 50, if not more, people that do travel with the Prime Minister. Then you also have to remember that the Prime Minister does have RCMP with him, and there's secure networks of communication, and moving a Prime Minister also has complications due to the security risk with that. So right now, we're sort of in a hole pattern. We know that this plane, it has a technical issue that means that we're not able to fly out of India tonight. And then, you know, there are also some questions about this plane itself. The Airbus in this fleet has been, you know, running as for decades it's been flying, and it's really reached the end of its lifespan. The federal government did sign a $3.6 billion contract to buy new planes. And, you know, many people expected these planes to be ready sometime soon. And in fact, before we left, there was actually one of the new planes, at least we were told one of the new planes, that was on the tarmac.
Right. Annie, they're reporting from the tarmac in New Delhi. Appreciate that update, Annie. Thank you for joining us.
What we focus on is the absence of China and even Russia, the leaders like Xi Jinping and Vladimir Putin. What are experts on the ground telling you? Do they feel that their absence has some sort of impact as far as what India could have achieved with this presidency and also the outcome of the summit?
Well, look, it's a very broad subject if we want to talk on this subject, but breaking it down for our viewers, then I personally feel that she was expecting what is going to happen in India, in New Delhi at G20 summit, because the way India has managed to build consensus, the way India has managed to overpower the Western countries, the G7 bloc, in